Hi, in this video I'll show how I can control this little robot I've made with the MicroBit. So the robot is made from two paper rolls, toilet paper rolls, and I have two LEDs, blue LEDs as eyes, and then I have a servo motor here to control the movement of his head, and yeah, that's it. So I've connected the LEDs to the pin 1 on the MicroBit here, and the pin 0 I've connected to the servo motor's orange wire here, which is the controlling wire. And then I connected the red to plus 3 and the brown to ground. I'll connect to ground in a while. So I've on the MicroBit I have I can control his eyes with turning it from open eyes and a happy smile and a closed eyes where he's asleep here. And when I shake, his eyes open and close 5 times. Now he's just asleep. Now he woke up. So let's see how it works with the servo. And then I connected the servo movement to the accelerometer on the X axis. So let's see how that works. So we see, I think I have forgotten something about his eyes. Just a minute. Why is it not showing any? Oh yeah, he's asleep, of course. So I put on his, I can turn off the light here. So you can see, I can turn this MicroBit, and then he's moving his head. And if you shake, he blinks 5 times. And then I can control his eyes also with the button A and button B, and look to the right or the left, look to the right. Yes, so this is quite fun. And shake him and he blinks. Oh no, don't shake me, he says. Okay, that's nice. Go play with the MicroBit and make your own robot from two paper rolls, two LEDs, and a servo motor. And don't forget to put this resistor between the LEDs and the MicroBit, or you'll burn the LEDs. But have fun! Hi, I'll show how I make the code to control the robot I made with the MicroBit. So we need to set up the servo and also the pin for the LED. So I put the servo on pin 0 and the LEDs for the robot's eyes on pin 1. Then I put on an event on the button A to open his eyes and an event on B to close his eyes. And then I'll put on a shake event to make a function that will open and close his eyes 5 times. Then I'll put an event on the accelerometer on the x-axis that will map to the servo, so his head will move according to the tilt of the MicroBit. So that's quite a challenge we have here, so let's get started. The first thing we need to set up is our pins. So we go down here to to the pins, and here I have something you need to set for the servo to function. It's some kind of pulse that's sent to the servos that'll set the position of the servo motor. So this is just a standard I'll put in here on P0, and the number is 20,000. And then I'll set the angle. I have an angle variable I like to use, so I'll put in a new variable here from the variables category, and I rename it to angle. Okay, and I'll start to set it to 90, so the head will point towards us when we run the start of the program. And then I also have to control the servo, so I'll just find the servo. Here I can't remember where it is. It's here. So I write, it's under the pins. So it's this one. So on pin 0, it's this one. You can see now we have a servo connected to when I put this on. Now it disappears. And when I put it back, the servo will pop up here. So to start, I'll set the servo to the angle. So I go to my variables and I'll find the angle variable here, and that will be 90. So now you can see it starts and it points in the forward direction. Then I want to, when I tilt the microbit, I will map the tilting, which goes from 0 to 1023. I'll map that to an angle between 45 degrees and 135 degrees. So his head will turn in an angle of something like 90 degrees. So I need a forever loop, and we have this here. And then I'll read the acceleration, and I'll write that to the servo. So I need this servo right again. So I duplicate this and I put it here. And then instead of angle here, I need to map a number. So I go down here to the pins again, and we have this big block here, which I put in here. And what this does is it maps a number from our input here. And this input is our acceleration. So I find that on my input. And you can see here we have the acceleration on the x-axis. So it's this x-axis. When I tilt the microbit in this axis, I can also choose the y-axis or the z-axis. The y is here and z is up from here. So it's mapping from a low value to a low value, and from a high value to a high value. So this acceleration, I think, goes from 0 to 123, and I want it to go from to 45. So the angle is pointing this way to high, and that's 135. And it's this angle here. So his head should turn from this position to this position when we tilt him. Then I put in a delay here, so we don't get reading alts every how fast it can read. So I just put in a delay of 1/10 of a second here. Okay, and now I want to make a function. When you press the button A, I want to turn his eyes on. So I make a function you know, functions. You can write your own function here, make a function. So I'll call this turn on ice. And where did that go? It's up here. And then I'll make a function where I write to digital pin 1. So I go here. No, I go to pins. It's down here under advanced. And I want to digital write to P1. That's the second one here. And I want to set the value to 1, which is high, meaning we send current to this one, and it there will be his eyes will light up. So I have to call my function from button A. So we can try this. Now I press button A, and you can see it turns on. And then, of course, I want to press button B. So I'll copy this one, duplicate this one, and I press B here instead of A. And then I want to make my a new function, and I want to call this turn eyes off. Okay, and it went up here. And then I want to copy this one. Control C, Control V. And then I want to set it to 0. So now I can try. I can turn on his eyes here and turn it off. I have to call it here. Turn eyes off. So on and off. On and off. Yes. And another thing I can do, I can put in an icon, an image on the microbit itself, so we can actually see what happens. So go into images, and I'll take this show image at offset 0. And then I'll pick an image of his eyes open. So I pick this icon image and put it here. And then I can find an face here, this happy face, and then I copy this, duplicate this, and put it here, and then I'll make him asleep, and I think it's this one. So now, when I press the button A, he should have a happy face, and I press button B, he's asleep. So now we only need the last thing, and that's the unshake event. So what's going to happen when I shake the microbit? He's going to turn off his eyes and on and off 6 times, I guess. So I need an unshake event. It's here under input. And I need to repeat something 6 times. So I'll drag this in and change the number to 6 times. And then I call my function turn on eyes. And I'll want a pause between this. So I'll take a pause here. And I set it to 300, 1/3 of a second almost. And then I want to turn off his eyes, so Control C, Control V, and I want a little pause again, Control C, Control V, and this will loop 6 times, so you can see here I can simulate the shake by pressing this one, and the eyes is on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, yeah, 6 times. And it's ended with eyes off, then we can put this one, and he's happy again. Yes. So that's how you control your robot, and have fun.
Thanks.